You know, Dustin, you can celebrate that illegitimate win all you want, but you've done nothing in there. Like, it was a hell of a first round. It would have been nice to get into that second round and then, you know, to see what's what. But it is what it is. That's the nature of the business. A clean break of the tibia, and it was not to be. That second round would have shown all.
I mean, come on. The odds of him turning that round and finishing Dustin in the second round, when round one is supposed to be Conor's best round. You know, it wasn't good. It wasn't a good performance. They will do a fourth fight. I think in the meantime, Dustin will go on, more than likely beat Charles Oliveira. He'll become the champion. And then we're going to see the fourth fight against Dustin for the belt.
I hear a lot of people saying round two, even Conor himself said round two was going to be different. I was going to change everything. I was going to do my thing, but nothing in those 5 minutes tells me that anything was going to happen differently. Dustin Poirier today is just really in his groove. Dustin's at the top of his game right now, and it showed in the octagon.
He put that sprint on Conor, forced him to panic, make mistakes, make his heart rate go up, and he was able to get the finish. It was phenomenal. I was happy for him. I feel like if anybody in that division that deserves that kind of success or money or accolades, it's Dustin. He put his time in, he's fought the best guys, and you know, he's starting to see the fruits of his labor.
You know, I thought it showed, you know, the charitable, nice guy, the true character of Dustin the Dupe Poirier. He's out there strutting in front of Conor's face. Obviously, it was a fluke, man. Conor broke his leg. It was a fluke decision. Ending, you know, it wasn't a knockout, it wasn't a clear-cut decision, what is it, a submission, you know, and the guys out there strutting in front of the guy's face, you know, at a downfall when that guy made his career and did everything for Dustin to give him this big fight. So I thought it was funny, it showed his true color character. You know, he's got his little prop for, you know, his wife Jolie out there. Obviously she's a prop, he only used her for a prop because, you know, he knows he's a piece of shit person. He wants to act like he's a nice guy, a family man, you know, a father and a good husband. So, you know, I just thought it showed his true character last night. He's a dirtbag, and so is the whole camp that he resides out of. And you know, he had to take him down because he was scared of the striking again. So he had to go for a takedown when he used to. He always hates on wrestlers, and he's like, oh, wrestlers are boring, blah, blah. Paid in full, fists and this and that, and violence and blah, blah, blah. But he's out there shooting for takedowns because he's scared to stand up.
I can hold on to most people fairly well, but he was like real, it's pretty elusive in the grappling. I was quite, you know, added like, just tipped my hat to him a couple times. Like, he was, yeah. There's a reason why he's one of the best fighters in the world.
If you want to talk about the best fighters in the world, I mean, you are talking to the best fighter in the world, but, you know, Dustin needs to come see a real fighter. For all his remarks he made in the media, oh, it's on site, it's this, that, when I see you. So, you know, be a man of your word. Otherwise, you know, you're just going to get exposed and the fans are going to know the real coward you were.
He gets paid well. He's got a ton of respect amongst his promotion. He just got a fight with Conor McGregor. The most exposure he'll ever have in his entire life. So stop playing the lack of respect card and let's just talk about fighting. Fight whoever they put in front of you. Chances are it's going to be a guy named Michael Chandler. I think you see a bit similar of shades of myself and Dan Hooker. I'm going to put Poirier on his back foot. I'm going to push him. I'm going to push him up against the fence. He's going to be fighting off of his back foot. He's not going to ever engage me. He's not going to ever put pressure on me or put me up against the cage where he is most dangerous. I'm gonna throw punches and bunches. I'm gonna put my hands on him. He's gonna be very, very, very surprised in my power. And I think I finish him within the first two rounds.
I just see me just giving him a wedgie in the middle of the octagon and just slapping him all around the octagon, throwing him from one side of the cage to the other until he quits, you know. It would probably be a verbal submission. He'd probably tap out and be the first fighter in a big high-profile fight to tap out from just getting just absolutely annihilated. So it wouldn't be competitive. And deep down inside, he knows that. But, you know, he talked reckless before, and I just want to keep him accountable for his words, you know. You know, his best money opportunity, if he wants to do good business, is to come up to 170 and see Daddy. You know, this is a personal rivalry. This isn't like I'm trying to pick on someone, you know, and there's no narrative to the fight. Man, this guy, we go back 10 years training together, you know, and he said some things to me in the gym. I've said some things to him. You know, there's deep, 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 deep personal issues with this drama and this beef. And I just hope they get settled in the octagon someday. But if they don't, you know, then the fans get to know who Daddy is. And they get to know that, you know, I'm really Parker's daddy, you know. And it's not Dustin who's Parker's daddy. I'm Parker's daddy. And I'm Jolie's husband.
Colby Covington does not care He was talking a lot of shit about Dustin Poirier, saying, you know, people going about Dustin the Diamond, what a great guy he is. But let me tell you, Dustin Poirier is a piece of shit. He was showing him a video. This is an amateur that came to the gym to spar, and then Dustin Poirier knocks him out, and then screaming, and new. And Colby's saying, this guy's a piece of shit. Who does that? Who knocks out an amateur guy like that? He comes into the gym, he's looking up to you, and Dustin knocks him out and screams, and new. That's who you're dealing with. By the way, Colby's words, not mine. I love me some Dustin Poirier.
When Dustin Poirier and Charles Oliveira step into the octagon, they will have had the longest UFC tenures between two guys fighting for a UFC championship, because together combined, they've had over 50 octagon appearances. I mean, Dustin Poirier joined some real elite company last weekend with his 20th win inside the octagon. But the matchup itself is so intriguing because it's hard to find where someone has an advantage, right? You would think Dustin's the striker, Oliveira has the most submissions in UFC history. You would think that Charles Oliveira is the guy that can handle the grappling, but it's not that simple. Dustin Poirier is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt himself. He has a ton of submissions. I mean, this is a guy that submitted Max Holloway back in the day.
Even like with me and Dustin, you know, everybody, the scoreboard or whatever, you know, everybody think it was lopsided or whatever people say. But at the end of the day, Dustin in there, the man himself, was saying that he felt like the third round was getting away from him. The fight was slipping away from him after the third round with me, so we'll see what happens.
But, and people were giving me a lot of stuff this week. They're like, oh, why are you picking on Dustin? Dude, Dustin weighs more than me. We used to weigh in at American Top Team all the time. The guy would weigh like 188, 190. I'm like 185. You know, I just don't want to cut a bunch of weight because I know I'm the best in the world at the weight class that I fight in. I don't have to look for a weight advantage and cut all this weight to feel like I'm the bigger guy. So, you know, all the people that are saying that, oh, stop picking on lightweights, I'm picking on a guy that's bigger than me. My bad. It's not my fault Dustin was saying to the media, oh, it's on site when I see Colby. But I've seen the guy 40 or 50 times since he said it's on site. So who's a man of their word? Who's not a man of their word?
To me, the respect level for a guy like Poirier, or even anybody in the division, I respect you if you step inside the cage and you make your living doing what I do. His heart, his determination, what he does outside the cage, the man that he is, the competitor that he is, the father that he is, and a lot of it comes with good things happen to good people, you know? And it's not that people don't do the right things, it's that people don't do the right things for long enough. And he has put his time in, grown into a phenomenal man, father, husband.
He beat a lot of good guys in lightweight division, a lot of tough guys, you know? He's a tough guy. He's not easy for nobody. His boxing is good. His movement, you know, he have experience. He fight more than 20 times in UFC, you know. He's a tough guy. Oh, you know, he's a great guy. He's family man, you know. He's doing some charity stuff.
But now, like, Dustin Poirier is like 32. He learned a lot. Even if he lose to me, I think from this loss he learned. After Conor fight, he learned, you know. And right now, I think he's prime time. Like mentally, I think he become better. I think he become better, he learn, you know, and he's not old.